Heidi is a popular novel written by Swiss author Johannes Pyry, published in 1881. Heidi is an orphan girl initially raised by her maternal grandmother and aunt Dieti in Mainfield in the Grisons. After the early deaths of her parents, Tobias and Adelaide, that is Dieti's brother-in-law and sister. Shortly after the grandmother's death, Dieti is offered a good job as a maid in the big city. She takes 5-year-old Heidi to her paternal grandfather's house up the mountain from the Dorfli, a small village in Swiss German. The arm uncle has been at odds and embittered against God for years and lives in seclusion on the arm, which has earned him the nickname the arm uncle. He briefly resents Heidi's arrival, but the girl's evident intelligence and cheerful yet unaffected genius soon earn his genuine if reserved love. Heidi enthusiastically befriends her new neighbors, young Peter the Gozer, his mother Brigitte, and his blind maternal grandmother. With each season that passes, the mountain top inhabitants, especially Peter and the grandmother, grow more attached to Heidi and she to them. However, the grandfather refuses to allow Heidi to attend school and quarrels with the local pastor and schoolmaster, who try to encourage him to do so. 3 years later, Dieti returns to take Heidi to Frankfurt to be a hired lady's companion to a wealthy girl named Clara Sissaman, who is unable to walk and regarded as an invalid. Despite the protest, Heidi was forced to be separated from her uncle and the mountains. Heidi arrives in Frankfurt with a heavy heart. Clara was her only comfort and companion. Clara is charmed by Heidi's simple friendliness and her descriptions of life on the arm, and delights in all the funny mishaps brought about by Heidi's naivety and lack of experience with city life. However, the Sessaman's strict housekeeper, Fräulein Rottenmeier, views the household disruption as wanton misbehavior. That is, she often misunderstood that Heidi is misbehaving with her and places the free-spirited Heidi under more and more restraint. Soon, Heidi becomes terribly homesick for the arm and grows alarmingly pale and thin. Her one diversion is learning to read and write. Motivated by Clara's grandmother, who shows her trust and affection and encourages her to believe in God and to pray. Though Clara took care of Heidi, her intractable homesickness leads to episodes of sleepwalking, where she goes downstairs and opens the front door. Fortunately, Clara's father, Mr. Sessaman, returns and with the help of his good friend, Dr. Clayson, solves the mysteries. Heidi was moonwalking and unconsciously opening the door. Doctor diagnosed her illness as homesickness and proposed Heidi getting back to mountains as the only valid treatment and cure for her condition. She returns to the mountains laden with presents for her friend, but finds one of her greatest pleasures is reading hymns to Peter's blind grandmother, who can no longer do so for herself. Her faith in God speaks to something in the arm uncle, and he returns to the Christian faith. He accompanies Heidi to church and that winter takes accommodation in the village so that she can attend school. Heidi and Clara continue to keep in touch and exchange letters. A visit by the doctor to Heidi leads him to eagerly recommend that Clara must visit Heidi, feeling assured that the mountain environment and the wholesome companionship will do her good. Clara makes the journey the next season and spends a wonderful summer with Heidi, becoming stronger on goat's milk and fresh mountain air. But Peter, who grows jealous of Heidi and Clara's friendship, pushes her empty wheelchair down the mountain to its destruction, although he is soon racked with guilt about what he did and ultimately confesses to it. Without her wheelchair, Clara was without her wheelchair, Clara has no choice but to learn to walk. She attempts to do so and is gradually successful. She is not very strong, often relying on Heidi or the grandfather to stay standing and not collapse, but it marks an end to her. Time is a lonely, shut invalid. Her grandmother and father are amazed and overcome with joy to see Clara walking again. The Sesemann family promises to provide permanent care for Heidi if there ever comes a time when her grandfather is no longer able to do so. The story ends with a blissful, happy ending. Thank you.